Hello everyone, myself Mrs. Shatabdi Dhar. Today in this video, I am going to discuss about the multi-level scheduling algorithm. Now what is multi-level queue scheduling? In the multi-level queue scheduling algorithm, partition, the ready queue has divided into 7 separate queues. Based on some priority of the process, like some memory size, process priority, or process type, these processes are permanently assigned to one queue. Each queue has its own scheduling algorithm. For example, some queues are used for the foreground process and some for the background process. The foreground queue can be scheduled by using a round robin algorithm, while the background queue is scheduled by a first come first serve, that is FCFS algorithm. It is said that there will be scheduled between the queues which are easily implemented as a fixed priority preemptive scheduling. Let us take an example of a multi-level queue scheduling algorithm with 5 queues like system processes, interactive processes, interactive editing processes, batch processes, and student processes. Each queue has absolute priority over lower priority queues. No process in the batch queue, for example, could run unless the queues for system process, interactive processes, and interactive editing processes were all empty. If an interactive editing process entered the ready queue while a batch process was running, the batch process will be preempted. In a multi-level queue scheduling algorithm, processes are permanently assigned to a queue on entry to the system. Processes do not move between queues. This setup has the advantage of low scheduling overhead, but the disadvantage of being inflexible. Now, what is multi-level feedback queue scheduling? Multi-level feedback queue scheduling allows a process to move between the queue. The processes are separate with different CPU burst time. If a process uses too much CPU time, then it will be moved to the lowest priority queue. This idea leaves input-output bound and interactive processes in the higher priority queue. Similarly, the process which waits too long in a lower priority queue may be moved to a higher priority queue. This form of aging prevents starvation. The multi-level feedback queue scheduler has the following parameters: the number of queues in the system, the scheduling algorithm for each queue in the system, the method used to determine when the process is upgraded to a higher priority queue, the method used to determine when to demote a queue to a lower priority queue, the method used to determine which process will enter in queue and when that process needs service. Hope through this video you can understand about the multi-level queues. So to get more update, don't forget to subscribe my channel.